Hey guys, it's Jessica from craftingandstampin.blogspot.com, and today is the Stuck on You Sketches 5-year anniversary blog hop. You should have arrived here, I believe, from Janice. I'm not 100% sure because I'm not at my computer right now, but I will have it listed down below. Our theme of the die cut hop is geometric shapes. So the first thing, honestly, that jumped into my mind was circles. So I knew I got this brand new Artfully Sent Cricut cartridge, and I am loving playing with it. I have quite a few cards that I'm in the middle of making, but I needed to contact Cricut first to make sure that some of the things were working properly in Design Space, but that's for another video. So here is the project that I wanted to make. It is this image right here. It was very, very easy. All you have to do is follow the size that it is made. This is actually considered an overlay card. So it's the shift sleeve if you're on a regular expression. But if you were in Design Space, you can actually just look for this. And what it's actually supposed to do is pull in even your layer piece. For some reason, the layers are not pulling in. So you could just cut a piece of cardstock that is roughly, what's for whatever color you want to be showing, at 4¾ by 6¾, and that'll make it equal 5x7, or we'll make it fit inside the 5x7. So, this was, like I said, the one that I did. It's on page 1 of the handbook. And now let me show you what it looks like. So here's the one that I created. I knew I wanted to use our new Confetti Wishes paper because I absolutely love this, because it didn't necessarily say celebrate of any kind, and I was going to do a celebrate card, but then I was like, well, no, I kind of need more birthdays. So this is an anniversary blog hop, but I'm also going to play it off like a birthday. So all I did was I followed exactly as it said, 5x7, and then I cut my thistle piece at 4¾ by, I believe I actually did 6⅞ is actually what this is. I apologize. And I just adhered it in here. But before I adhered my thistle piece, I used our 1-inch circle punch, and I punched out some coordinating colors from the Confetti Wishes and just randomly stuck them inside the loose, or the negative spots on the card base. And then I also use some of the Confetti Wishes assortments, which is this, and the compliments, which are these pieces right here. I use some of our silver sequins, and I colored them in with the Shinhan Twin Touch markers that we offer. And look how cool it is. I can get them to match with the colors of my paper. I also used thistle ribbon along here and here, and I used our very handy mini stapler, which I just love this thing. I swear, I think I use it on every project now. It fits like right in the palm of my hand. It's really comfortable, and you can chick, 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 right across. See, like how I did that? Chick, chick, chick. but anyway, so super fun, super easy. I also even used the amazing stamp set that comes with this. Let's see if I can reach it from here. I know I read it on a video yesterday, the unboxing, but here we go. I also use the great sentiments that are in this. This stamp set you can actually only get if you purchase the Artfully Sent, and it's the Just to Say Cricut collection. I mean, there's sentiments for everything in here, and I actually use this happy birthday. So, I really hope you enjoyed my card, and I hope you continue hopping along. You are going to go to Katie, I will make sure I mention all her info down below. And that is all. So, thank you so much for watching. I hope to catch crafting and stamping. Bye. Oh, I'll also put the link down below. I'm so sorry for those of you that want to purchase the Artfully Sent Cricut cartridge from me. So, thanks so much for watching. Bye.